love. Choose life and give me a chance to see the world. I give every other boy and girl a chance to tell the world that I'm alive. Give me the light.
Hello, welcome to our program, St. Gerard Center for Life. We are a Catholic Pregnancy Resource Center, and we're located in the inner city of Hartford, very close by Hartford Hospital. And the key mission of our center is to save babies' lives and souls. And as you can see from this video, we are strategically located across the street from the Hartford GYN abortion facility, which tragically, every single week, numerous babies are being killed at that facility. So we are going there, and we're reaching out with the love and compassion of Jesus and letting those mothers know that we'll do whatever we can to save their precious baby's life. And we're excited now because our program has expanded. Through the efforts of the Knights of Columbus, we were able to raise the necessary funding to purchase an ultrasound machine. And so because of that great blessing from God, we are able to now do ultrasound services here at 22 Maple Avenue, which is very significant because, unfortunately, many of the women go across the street to the Hartford GYN. They maybe just be going for an ultrasound. However, when they go there to that location, they are immediately told about, informed about terminating their baby. They're immediately recommended to have an abortion on demand. And so we want to be able to offer these women the support that they need and an ultrasound so that we can save their baby, and which is so critical that we are using this beautiful ultrasound technology to save babies' lives. So we began to do these wonderful ultrasound services in April of 2011. And we have done well over 100 scans. We now are blessed. We have Dr. Judy Mascolo. She is the medical director of our program. And we also have two Catholic nurses, Joan Anderson and also Barbara Burkhardt. And they've been serving at our program for free. They're all working as volunteers. And it's just been going extremely well. We've just been so blessed.
I'm Dr. Mascolo, the medical director of St. Gerard Center for Life, and a couple of months ago we started our new initiative where we are doing prenatal ultrasounds. We are here to diagnose and confirm intrauterine pregnancy in women in hopes that they choose life. We've been very successful. We try to do about 4 or 5 ultrasounds a week. We're getting girls from all over the greater Hartford area, and we've had a lot of fascinating cases and stories from these young women who, because they see the baby on the screen, on the ultrasound screen, are choosing to keep their babies and choosing life. Right now we have two nurses who are also trained in prenatal ultrasounds and an ultrasound technician who comes and assists us. We are all volunteers here. We spend about 1 full day a week providing these services, and hopefully in the future, as our numbers increase, we can offer it 2 or maybe even 3 days a week.
Hi, I'm Barbara Burkhardt. I'm a registered nurse. I recently retired about 3-4 years ago, and I've gone for training in limited obstetrical sonography, ultrasonography. And I've been doing ultrasounds at St. Gerard's from about April on. We do girls who are anywhere from 6 weeks to maybe 20 weeks pregnant. We basically are looking for 3 things. We look for an intrauterine pregnancy, we look for a viable pregnancy for a heartbeat, and we do some measurements. This takes about maybe a half an hour, but it's amazing that in this time we get to know these girls a little bit, and going through this with them, we find it's exciting always. We never fail to get excited over showing them this little baby and seeing the baby move, watching it together, printing pictures for them, having family members look at the baby, and it's a wonderful experience. At the end of our exam, we usually pray with the girls, and we send them on their way much happier and more positive about life. We're constantly amazed. We find ourselves just talking to each other about the beauties of life and how exciting it is to see the little heartbeat, even in a little tiny grain of rice, and the baby is just ever so small, and to look at the development of the baby as we go along. We have the girls sometimes come back and be models for us. We're always looking for people to be a model up to about 20 weeks, and that's just for our experience so that we learn more. So actually, if you know anyone who's pregnant up to 20 weeks and would like to come and be a model for us, please call St. Gerard's.
And we're excited to share that through these ultrasound services, and of course the grace of Almighty God, because we couldn't do anything without God's grace, that 7 babies' lives have been saved, which otherwise would have died from abortion. And we never take any credit for that. That is truly the power of Jesus and the Blessed Virgin Mary working in the hearts of these mothers, that they would do God's holy will and choose life for their babies. And we were again blessed. Our program, as I said, has expanded, and now we have a second location. The second location is also in Hartford, and it's on 59 Eaton Street. We felt that it was very important to be able to have a program that, of course, would show the woman their baby in the womb, save the baby's life, but then also to have a program that would nurture the baby's life. And on 59 Eaton Street, we have a program called St. Gerard's Support Service Center. And at that location, we provide all the supports that the mother will need to have her baby. Car seats, strollers, bassinets, diapers, formula, clothing, any support that they would need to have their baby. We also individually work with each mother to assess what their needs are. So if they are looking for employment or trying to find housing, we will specifically work with them to address those needs. We also have a program which helps the mothers live a chaste life. We have a chastity program, and that's entitled Keeping Hearts Pure. And this beautiful program is coordinated by one of our volunteers, Mary Ives. We have these classes every Saturday, and it's mandatory for the women to attend the classes in order to really receive the support services from the program. And we just really truly believe that these women, through the grace of God, can live a chaste life. And we want them to recognize that they have dignity as women and as mothers. And we use the Blessed Virgin Mary as the example of course, the greatest mother of all mankind, the Queen of Heaven and Earth, and her as the greatest model of purity. So we just have the girls aspire to her and know that they can truly live a chaste life. And so these classes are geared to help them recognize that their body is the temple of the Holy Spirit and their body is sacred, and that intimacy is only meant inside of marriage, never outside the context of marriage. And then we also speak about all forms of birth control, both in and outside of marriage. And of course, as we're speaking about chastity, we would speak out against all forms of birth control. And we help the ladies understand how destructive birth control is to their body, but also to their soul, that it truly is so damaging to them. And we want the girls to realize that, you know, they are not objects. They're not a means to an end. And to really recognize the gift of their dignity, the gift of beginning to gain the self-respect, and the gift of being able to have a secondary virginity, to begin all over again. And that's something that we emphasize. Recognize that in God, we're all a new creation. We also help our mothers through a baptism preparation program. We want our girls to know that if they would like, they can actually have their children enter into the Catholic Church, become baptized Catholics. They themselves, if they choose, would become Catholic as well. And one of the reasons that we offer this program is we really believe that the only way abortion will come to an end is once a young lady truly knows the love of Jesus Christ. That once the true love of Christ exists in the heart of a woman, then abortion will be an unthinkable reality. We won't need laws. We won't need, really, other than prayer, we always will need prayer, but essentially that's the aim of helping the girls reestablish their relationship with Jesus Christ. And this is something that we don't coerce. It's an option that's presented to the mothers, but many of them love the opportunity. And since we've begun this program, more than 50 children have become baptized as Catholics. And this past year, in April 2011, one of the mothers actually entered into the Catholic Church. And one of our volunteers, Christina Berger, was the mentor and the sponsor of this mother. And it was just really a beautiful, awesome gift that she received, the gift of faith, which I believe is the best gift we can give our mothers in the program. And also, we have a program that will reach out to those women who have experienced the tragedy of abortion. We truly want them to know God's love and God's mercy and God's healing. And yes, we want them to know that abortion is a forgivable sin. And we want them to go on that journey of healing and that journey of forgiveness. And so for those mothers who are Catholic, if they so choose, we will help them to receive the sacrament of reconciliation. And for the other young ladies, we will also help them walk through that journey through some mentoring sessions. We will help them go to Rachel's Vineyard, any type of program that will help them to begin to know the mercy of God and begin that process of healing and forgiveness and God's mercy.
Also, another part of our program is serving couples in the program. We have couples that we try to encourage to get married, that would like to get married and ask for our assistance, and also couples that are married. And for our married couples, we speak to them about natural family planning. Many of them may not be or not aware of it, had not learned about natural family planning, and we help them understand that this is a beautiful way to, that God had intended to regulate the births or the number of children that they would like to have, and you know, again, all according to God's plan, and of course being open to the sacredness of life at any point, if God would so choose to give them a child at any point, that they would be welcoming of that child. So we do that, and I think it's a very important part of our work, because many times when the mothers leave our program and they go to the hospital, different hospitals have recommended that they use all different forms of contraception. So they may offer them the pill, they may offer them the IUD, many other ways in which they would contracept, and so they feel there's no other alternative, so they just do it. And so we find that by giving them this information prior to the wife having her child, that she is equipped to know that she can reject all the offers of contraception and totally realize that the natural family planning is a very beautiful way in which a couple can grow closer together, and to also be open to God's will for a child, So it's a beautiful, beautiful process, and we promote this in a great way. And so those are the very facets of our program, and we just really believe that God's grace is with us, and we constantly pray for it. And I believe that through the power of the Holy Spirit, countless babies' lives and souls will be saved through, I pray, our program, St. Gerard's. God bless you.
Thank you, Maya, choosing me.
Hey. is a sign ahead, pointing to the world. And if you follow it, you won't be alone. You know the choice is here. The truth is clear. Take me with you now. Choose love, choose life, and give me a chance to see the world. Like every other boy and girl, a chance to tell the world that I'm alive. Give me the life that I deserve. Discover God and to Him serve. Believe in Him and know that you chose right. And find the strength inside. Take me with you now. Choose love, choose life, and give me a chance.